Within Azure AI Studio, the Moderate Text tool provides the capability for you to quickly try out text moderation for a bulk set of records. In this demo, we'll demonstrate how to run a bulk test on a set of records and how you can configure the filters and adjust the harm category threshold levels to suit your needs. To learn more about harm categories and severity levels, visit aka.ms/harm-categories. For tests run on a bulk set of data, the dataset must be provided within a CSV file that is formatted with two columns titled Record and Label. The Record column contains all the content to be evaluated by the tool. The Label column contains either a 0 or 1 for the corresponding record. A 0 indicates that the content is acceptable or not harmful, and a 1 indicates that the content is unacceptable or harmful. You could download the sample CSV file and use that as a template to format the records. I'm using a sample dataset of customer inquiries and reviews from the Contoso Camping Store. I've reviewed each record and provided a label based on Contoso Camping Store's community content guidelines. When I later run the test, I want to validate whether the model can accurately identify the harmful content in the dataset. Within the Moderate Text Content tool, I'll switch to the Run a Bulk Test tab to upload the dataset and run the test. The dataset is uploaded in step 1 and can be viewed in the dataset preview section in step 2. Let's keep the threshold levels set to medium and run the test. The results provide a series of metrics which can help guide you in modifying the threshold categories as needed. The first result is the proportion of allowed versus blocked content. In this example, 86.7% of the records are allowed and 13.3% of the records are blocked. The maximum value for the precision, recall, and F1 scores are 1. Ideally, we'd want the result to be as close to 1 as possible. The precision metric reveals how much of the content the model identified as harmful is actually harmful. It's a measurement of how precise or accurate the model is. The model scored 0.50 or 50%. The recall metric reveals how much of the actual harmful content the model correctly identified. It's a measurement of the model's ability to identify actual harmful content. The model scored 0.30 or 30%. The F1 score metric is a function of precision and recall. It's needed when you seek a balance between precision and recall. The model scored 0.40 or 40%. While the model is doing okay, there's room for improvement in both identifying more harmful content and not mislabeling too much harmless content. The severity details per record section provides a view of each record and the severity level across each enabled category. The judgment column consists of either allowed, blocked, allowed with a warning, or blocked with a warning. The warnings are an indication that the general judgment from the model is different from the corresponding record label. You could adjust the threshold levels within the Configure Filters section to fine-tune the model. Since most of the records judged as allowed with warning have a threshold for hate as low, we could adjust the filter to fine-tune the model and improve the scores. And finally, the Severity Distributed by Category section provides a graph of the distribution across categories. This graph considers the number of records that were judged to be safe compared to the records for the corresponding category, which were either low, medium, or high. Now that we've reviewed the results, we can make a better informed decision on what may need to be modified within the threshold levels for the harm categories. Let's first start by changing the threshold level for hate to low and run the test. We now have a change in the proportion of content that's allowed versus blocked. Before, we had an 86.7% and 13.6% split. After adjusting the threshold level for hate, 76.7% of the records are allowed and 23.3% are blocked. The precision has an increased score of 0.70 or 70%. This is good and shows that we're moving in the right direction by modifying the filters. The 0.60 for the F1 score suggests that the model is improving in both correctly identifying harmful content and avoiding false alarms. This score indicates an improved balance between both precision and recall. There are also now fewer records labeled with judgment warnings. Since most of the records judged as blocked with warning have a threshold for violence as low, we could adjust the filter to fine-tune the model and improve the scores. I'll set the threshold level for violence to low and run the test again. The model is continuing to improve. The proportion of allowed versus blocked content has changed again. The model has detected that 70% of the records are allowed and 30% are blocked. There's now both an increase in precision, which is now 0.80, and recall, which is now 0.90. In summary, these results indicate that while the model is particularly good at catching all the harmful content, it may occasionally mislabel some harmless content as harmful. However, the overall performance, as indicated by the F1 score of 0.80, is still quite strong. There are a few records that remain with a judgment warning. A recommended next step could be to review each record that remains and decide whether the record was mislabeled in the uploaded dataset. Such judgment warnings are helpful in the sense that the model provides another safeguard to catch whether content is acceptable. To get started with text moderation, visit ai.azure.com.